down and dirty. Tips and tricks for keeping your plane out of the shop. Starring Steve Dirty Hands. Today, stiffen up your wood. Spar, that is.
The hands are back. This is a wood center spar from a BF-110 made by Durafly. It's a nice little plane, except that it's got this wood center spar. And, you know, in my experience, this isn't the best plywood in the world. So, we like to beef this up.
Where's the beef?
And you can do it pretty easily with carbon fiber. We're using is some 2mm by 10mm carbon fiber rods, I guess you would call them bars, and we're going to cut away a groove on each side of this baby to accommodate one of those things so that the dimensions stay the same when we're done. While we're at it, going to stick it out past the end and drill that into the wing foam so it goes past the pocket and also makes it stronger like that. So what we have when this is done is that these babies will cross over each other in the middle like this, one on each side. It's going to stiffen this thing up like you won't believe. First, we cut this. Then we cut this. So I already cut this to length, and then what we have to do is trim it down so it becomes this dimension. It's a bit wider than that. And we need to cut this angle off where it's sticking out at the bottom. So it's going to be like that. We have to trim that off. And we have to trim this stuff off that sticks out. So first, we're going to trim our piece. And we have to cut what's called a rabbit. And we're going to cut it in here with a table saw. So we have to trim off 2mm worth of this thing. So first thing I do is find 2mm. Okay, I'm going to the edge of my blade. And I guess I'll need just a little less than that. And I'm pretty sure I've got my height of 10mm already set. Let's check that out. It's looking good. So I should be able to trim a rabbit on each side of this baby. One on this side, one on this side, and then inset my carbon fiber. Let's try it. Make sure you use a shark. You don't want to stick your fingers in a blade like that. Things can go wrong fast. It's a 10mm high now. Yes, it is. And now, let's try this. And see if that's 2mm thick. Yes, it is. That's lovely. So, we'll send it through. Here's where the shark comes in handy. That's lovely. But it appears to me to be a shade more than 2mm. That's okay, we'll live. Now, let's do the same thing on the other side.
And now we trim the angle on the carbon fiber.
I like this.
And now, I got a piece that fits in my little groove there like that on each side.
Now we've done a light sanding and we've got some quick grip from Beacon Adhesives.
This is like a really thick contact cement that's made of more or less plastic. It works really well. We're going to put a blob on here and then we're going to put this on here and squish it down to get the glue all over. We take it off and put it on a few times because that's what they tell you to do. I think they're trying to get you to get air in there. And we're going to push this all the way over to the end here so that it's tight up against our cut that we made with our saw. So now we'll just clamp that baby down for a little while. Notice that I'm putting these on at an angle. That's because clamps pull depending on whether you have put them on completely straight or not. And if you put them on something narrow and they're pulling to the side, they'll pull it right off. If your clamp is angled this way, it will push the piece away from the edge. And if your clamp is angled this way, it'll pull the piece off the edge, like that, when you clamp together. So it's better to have it clamped on an angle because it doesn't affect the edge so much if the clamp is off center.
Now we're ready for
the last part. Same glue, little tiny parts. I don't feel like getting covered with this stuff, so I've marked out where these are going to go. These are essentially straps that are going to go across like this from side to side at the top of the middle, and that'll strengthen it up somewhat. You'll have to pull these apart in order to get those to bend down at that point. And I like that idea, so let's glue them on. We will apply our glue in a nice goopy line. And now we flip our part, put it at our marks, which, thank the Lord, are there. Otherwise, I'd be sliding this glue-covered little part all over everything. Let's wipe off some of the excess. Let's wipe off some of the excess with one of these. Remove and reposition a couple of times. And glue that baby down. Let's glue the other one on the other side. So, now I'm going to let that glue dry. Let's get rid of our marking tape. And once again, if you want, you can clamp these, which I will do. Alright, so here's the final thing. We have our wood original beam, which now has carbon fiber on each side, and also carbon fiber pieces in the middle, spanning the center. We also put in a couple of, you know, like 10-inch other spars. This center of this wing now, at this dihedral angle, is ludicrously strong. It's as if it were a single solid piece made of much more than foam, which is what it is, isn't it? It is the thing to do with your plane. If you have a wooden spar, this is the way to go with it. So, take it from there. We'll see you on the flat line. Woohoo!